In this video, I'm going to show you how to do the ghost effect very easily in DaVinci Resolve. The ghost effect is a very simple and easy effect to achieve, and I'm going to teach you how to do this effect in less than a minute. The first step is to duplicate our video. We copy and paste, and place it one on top of the other. When we have finished placing the two clips well, we have to click on the video above and go to the Inspector tab. We click, and now in the composite section, we must lower the opacity to 50%. The next step is to select in which parts of the video we want the ghost effect, and in what parts not. For example, I don't want the ghost effect at the beginning of the video, so I deleted the whole first part of the clip, so. Now I want the effect to continue until here. In this part, I want the effect to disappear. With the knife tool, cut the parts that I don't want to have the ghost effect. In short, we must cut and delete all the parts of the video above in which we don't want the ghost effect to be. It would look like this. The video starts without ghost effect. Here the effect appears, the effect disappears, it reappears, and ends without effect. Now we must change the speed of all the parts that we have chosen. We change the speed to 90%, we click on accept. And we do the same again in the other part, we change to 90%. We will have our ghost effect only in the parts of the video that we have chosen. You can also modify the size and position of the effect to give it a different touch. DaVinci Resolve has another way of doing this effect automatically. We are going to see how it is done. We must go to the color module of DaVinci Resolve. We click on the node that we want to apply in the ghost effect. We go to the effects tab and look for the motion trails effect. We click on it and we drag to our node. The effect will be applied to us. I recommend lowering the trail length and values between 1 to 3. The more you increase, more ghost copies there will be. And this can be a bit chaotic. So I recommend putting from 1 to 3 ghost copies. Now adjust the drop-off parameter. If we increase the value, the ghost copies will be seen more. I will put it in the middle. To modify the position of all the ghost copies, you must modify the x-axis, zoom and rotation settings. You already have your ghost effect finished. If you want to learn how to do other effects, you can stop by my channel and take a look at my other videos. See you in the next video.